really hope that the movie gets the recognition that it deserves.
Oh, thank you. That's so kind of you, Nasser.
But my first question is, how did the socio-political landscape of the past years shape the story and the way you approach the story as a co-writer, as a director?
Well, look, the movie started off with a really fantastic play written by an incredible writer, J.C. Lee. And these are all issues that have preceded the writing of the play and certainly the moment we're in right now. They're complex issues that have to do with race and gender and class. So we did not try to capitalize on what's going on right now. JC in the writing process started with the characters. For me, in the conceptualization of it as a film, started with the characters as well. It was about how do we stay true to who these people are and their philosophies, their point of views, and the decisions they make. And in the course of doing so, it's inevitable that that's going to collide with these incredibly powerful issues that we're dealing with. And that is where I started as a director, as a co-writer, as a producer on the film. And I think it probably also influenced where they started as actors.
How much information you needed, how many answers you needed about the character to portray him versus keeping some of the mystery or some room to interpretation?
You know, as an actor, I have to have the answers for everything. I need to know, why am I doing this? Why am I headed there? What's my intention? Even if I don't, and also acknowledge the fact that I'm playing a 17-year-old kid who doesn't always know what this is, but I know why I feel the reason to do certain things, and just kind of leading with that and allowing Julius to do what he does so brilliantly, it was just is to edit and make the film, you know? And so I just play the truth, and he's gonna leave what you don't want to know and what you do and need to know for the audience to see.
Talking about the acting, I mean, it is so amazing, and we're gonna talk about all of them. Great work. My question is, for you as an actor, how much do you feel of that intensity and that level of excellence?
With the cast?
Yes.
Oh, you mean, as soon as I walk through the door, I'm like, so Octavia Spencer's here, and okay, cool, check. Naomi Watts, lovely, nice to see you, Mulholland Drive. Oh, and Tim Roth, great, fantastic. Let's do work. Cool. I'll try to show up. And so I definitely feel it, but I'm so grateful to be in the room with those people, you know?
How much of the story, in a way, is also kind of works as a commentary on how minorities, and in particular young African Americans, are depicted on film, when the character is talking about, we have to choose either to be an angel or a monster?
Well, you know, it's a very fair question. Ultimately, it's asking who has to live their lives on a symbolic level and who gets access to the full spectrum of humanity. And we live in a culture, especially for those who are typically in minority or subjugated groups, where the minute you do one thing that is perceived as wrong, you're put in one category, or you have to be perfect. And that is a serious, real question to ask about, well, who gets to live in that gray middle? Who gets to have flaws and maybe one day still become president of the United States? And who, you know, ends up in jail because they make one mistake? And as we continue to talk about power and privilege in this country and how it's allocated, we have to ask ourselves the hard questions about how our perceptions of each other put people in boxes and also ultimately hurt and damage people and their ability to be human.
Amen. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.